don't know if you know Robert Lipson, if any of you know the name Robert Lipson. One of the great, great pedagogues there is. I never studied with him, but I got a chance when I was a teenager to be around him all the time, and I sat in on his lessons and on his violin classes. And so I would ask him from time to time for advice. And at this particular moment in my life, I was having an existential crisis with big shifts. Okay, so it was Brahms Concerto. And I was really sweating it. Okay? It got to the point where I was, before I went on stage, the only thing I could think about was that moment. Okay? I didn't care about anything else. And of course, when you obsess about it, then you play that spot and it sounds horrible. So I went to him the next day and I said, "What, Mr. Lipson, what am I doing? You know, what? Tell me, what am I doing mechanically wrong? And how come I can't play this?" And he said, "Look, I never thought you had a problem. But if you think you have a problem, you have a problem." he's very, he kind of talks like this all the time. A little bit deadpan. So he said, "Let me ask you something. Are you good at brushing your teeth?" And I didn't know where he was going. I said, "Yeah." "Why?" "Because you should send this video to him, by the way." "Oh, why?" "I guess because I've done it every day since I was two or something." "Twice a day, right?" "Yeah." I said, "So, practice big shifts for 5 minutes, twice a day. Come back and tell me in a year how it's going." And I thought, I was a little bit older than me, I was probably 17 or 18 or something, but, and I thought, "A year? What are you talking about?" Then I thought, well, if I was 17, then in a year I'll be 18. And if I can do big shifts easily, if I'm not scared of them, that's pretty good, right? And I started practicing them 10 minutes a day. In a month, I was over it. I wasn't so worried about it. Just woke up, first thing I did when I picked the violin up was just start to just hit or miss, just do it again. And start to just figure it out. And eventually, you don't want to hear yourself play so badly, right? You'll figure it out. But to have that kind of patience